Hello everyone, my name is Elliot and I'm talking about generosity today. Generosity. I really hope that today you are encouraged to be generous, you're reminded of God's generosity and his purpose for you as well. He wants to use you. So, generosity. I wonder who comes to mind when you think of generosity. Maybe there's someone who you think they are the most generous person in the world. Or perhaps you remember someone being very generous to you. Well, I remember three people, in fact, being very generous to me recently. And it stuck with me because it was unexpected. The first occasion was a couple from church who brought round to my house a bag. And in that bag, it had loads of my favourite things. It had beef jerky, some biltong, which is like beef jerky, some chewing gum, some salt and sweet popcorn, some Nescafe Azira, all the beautiful things, right? And a beautiful card with a long message in it to say just that they appreciated me and to thank me, I guess, for the work I've been doing this year, which I don't need thanking for. And so, yeah, it was completely unexpected. And another time, shortly after, many of you will know Adam Roberts, and I play a game with him and a few other people. We're doing it online at the moment. But over Christmas, we agreed to exchange gifts. So I took my present round to Adams. And he had for me a massive bag. In fact, I've got the bag here. This was full to the top with wrapped presents. And on top of that, if that wasn't enough, he got me this, which is like a remote control Mario Kart, which is going to be awesome when we're allowed to use it in the Grace Centre. And yeah, I was just really, I was moved, I was touched. I was shocked in a way at how incredibly generous he'd been to me. I just wasn't expecting that whatsoever. And as I thought about this, I just really recognised that the generosity that those people showed me just reflected God's generosity and his kindness towards us. I really believe generosity is like one of God's character traits in a way. You know, the reason I'm here today is because God has provided for me every day. My mum prayed the other day and she said, God, you've given us more than we need. And it's so true. I've always had more than I need. So I'm just reminded of that. And I think I love generosity. I don't know about you. I'm pretty sure it's quite difficult to associate any negative thoughts with generosity, isn't it? But I think one of the things I like about it is that, and one of the things that excites me is that anyone can do it. I can be generous. Because in a way, generosity is relative to what we have, our resources. And there's this beautiful story in the book of Mark, chapter 12. I'll just read it. Verses 41 to 44. And he sat down, this is Jesus, opposite the treasury and watched people putting money into the offering box. Many rich people put in large sums. And a poor widow came and put in two small copper coins, which make a penny. And Jesus called his disciples to him and said to them, truly I say to you, this poor widow has put in more than all those who are contributing to the offering box. For they all contributed out of their abundance, but she, out of her poverty, has put in everything she had, all she had to live on. And when I read that, it doesn't tell us much about her, but I don't read it as if she's begrudgingly going and putting it in, right, I've got to give this, blah, blah, blah. I read it as if she knows who God is. She recognizes that God is her generous, providing father who loves her more than anything and has provided for her every day of her life. And Well, I don't know about you, but when I read that, I love it, but also it's uncomfortable to read because I know that I'm not like that widow. Yeah. Yeah. Generosity. So who are you going to be perhaps generous with your money to? There's a lot of needs in the world, aren't there? So many. And I'm sure you can show love to a friend, a family member, a neighbour, perhaps. And it doesn't even need to be money, I don't think. One thing, in fact, let me tell you two things that Mark Stone said. The first thing he said was, every good idea is a God idea. The other thing that I remember him saying is that when we give our time and our attention to people, it communicates value to them. And that's always stuck with me because we've all got time, we've all got attention, and we can use it to actually make a difference in people's lives, to show them how valuable they are, to show them they're worth something, to show and reflect God's love to them as well. So yeah, I'll just finish there. But let me ask you two questions. First, how has God been generous to you? Maybe spend a moment or two thinking about that today. And secondly, who or what organization maybe could be a charity or something working in another nation anywhere. What who are you going to be generous to with your time, your attention, your money, your whatever resources you've got? Maybe write a letter to someone, I don't know. Yeah, so let me pray. Not that you would stop me praying, I know. Father God, we thank you that you are a God of generosity, a God of many, many, many good gifts. And thank you, God, that there are too many things to name, in fact, in every one of our lives. Lord, I pray that you help us to recognize that, help us to remember the way you've been generous to you. And Lord, we choose today, we want to be generous. We want to be generous to others so that we might, in turn, show other people you. May people see you in our generosity. Amen.